In this week's vlog, I'm going to be doing a sort of a prep for a talk I'm giving this Friday on effective communications. This was brought on by an email I received from someone asking me to give them some help. The help they wanted was, you know, they receive emails from clients or partners, just people in general, and those emails sometimes seem kind of strange. A lot of exclamation points, large text. Hey, Maya. Hey, actually, go give that to your mother and your grandma. This mango
cake. Grandma's from Okinawa. Gone with empty diet on.
She did? Well, go give that to your mother. Say daddy brought that from Okinawa, okay?
All right.
No worries, baby. Close the door behind you.
All right. Stop saying that.
Okay, I will. So, moving on. This person receives emails from people, and the impression she gets from the emails are different from the impression she gets from the person. The emails seem to be, in short, a little unprofessional, sort of presents an image of the person that may be too pushy or too direct or sometimes rude. But the person they meet is kind and caring and open and just the kind of person you would want to communicate with. So what she was feeling, the person who wrote me was feeling, was she wanted to help these people so that perhaps if they met someone who, you know, or they were going forward with their business, that they would continue to give, you know, better impressions, you know, to help themselves going forward. So here are some quick tips, and I'll get into those tips the moment my daughter comes in. Hold on a second. Okay, you ready?
Ready.
Okay, let's talk about tips. Daddy's going to be talking about tips for effective communication.
Effective communication means something that's very expensive.
No, it's not expensive. I'm going to do it for free.
Oh, free.
Yes.
It's for free.
Yes.
Papa's going to do it.
Right. Okay, here we go. Oh, it's another one. Come here. Wait, you go here. And then, you're wearing a Cinderella dress. Come here. Let's talk to people about effective communication. Okay?
Effective communication is Daddy's going to say free.
Yes. Yeah,
so
free.
So listen, all right?
Okay, so here we go. The first thing about effective communications
is free.
Yes, is that it's free. You don't need to pay anything to have effective communications.
I like communication.
Yeah, and I like free, don't you?
Yeah, free.
Yeah, free. Okay, now, the second part about effective communication is that when you're emailing people, here are some points, is that we are, like for instance, let me ask you a question. Who's your favorite person?
Everyone.
Yeah, I know everyone. But who's the most favorite person in the whole world for you?
Hmm.
Who do you like the most in the whole world?
Teachers.
Teachers. What about yourself? Do you like you?
Yeah.
Exactly. You like you. What about you, Hannah? Do you like yourself? Yes, you burped. Yeah, she likes herself. The most important person in anyone's journey is themselves. And so when you're writing to someone, the first thing to do for effective communications is to write something about them. Something that acknowledges what they do. So for instance, what I will do if I'm dealing with a client or someone like that, I'll write, you know, in the first sentence or the first two sentences, something about something I remembered upon meeting them or something that's related to them. So for instance, if someone is interested in diving, I'll say, you know, it's good to meet you the other day. Great advice on diving. Oh, by the way, last week I saw X.
X marks the spot.
Yes, strictly in diving and pirate maps, right?
Yeah, okay. Pirate maps. Ahoy!
Ahoy, matey. So that's the first thing, is to acknowledge them. Okay.
Acknowledge them, yes. It means how to remember them, how they can remember.
Yes. Who they are, yes. You remember something important, makes them feel good. You acknowledge them.
Subconscious effect. And makes you good if you do something that you want.
Yeah, they will. Well, I guess what you're trying to say is if, you know, you do something good for them, they'll do what you want, which is hopefully what will happen at the end. Let me finish, okay? Let me finish this one thing. And then the second thing about effective communication. Don't imitate your father. Let daddy speak because he's doing this for free, okay?
I want to.
I know you do. I'll let you do a video. You know what I'll do? When we're done, I'll let you do a video, okay?
All right.
Okay, if you be quiet.
Hannah, stop touching Papa's things.
It's okay. We'll do. You can touch the things. So the second part about effective communication, listen, I'll let you do a video, okay? I promise. The next bleep vlog will be you, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'll let you do it. I'll even give you a script, okay? Okay?
Right.
You're right? Okay.
Who are you going to laugh?
So the second part about effective communication is exclamation points and emotion. Nothing wrong with emotion. If you're an emotional person, you be that person. Like this one over here giggling. She's emotional. And it's a beautiful thing. But a lot of times emotion is best used towards something about the client. So if you're going to use an exclamation point, rather than use it about your service, saying this is the greatest service in the world, use that exclamation point to acknowledge someone, saying, wow, that was a great cake you made, or that was something like that. And first and foremost, and last, sorry, last but not least, when it comes to effective communication, is being genuine, okay? If there's something about your client you don't like, it's going to come out in your email. Or if you don't care or don't know about their business, yes, boo, bad. If something you don't know, it's going to come out. So you're going to want to write something. You're going to want to really feel what it is you're writing.
That's not nice.
So if there's nothing to feel, be short.
You're doing it in.
What am I doing?
You're doing it in. I want to do it out. You're doing it in.
What's out mean?
Out means when you're playing or you're listening or you're talking something that's outside, mm-hmm. or you're talking about everything that's outside.
Oh, talking about everything that's outside. Okay, I'll talk about something that's inside, like what, like you?
Oh, I don't know.
I'll talk about you. Can I talk about you?
I don't like inside. I like outside. Okay. Butterfly.
Butterfly. Okay, let's you know what? Let your daddy be creative. Let's talk about butterflies, okay?
Oh, I know butterflies.
I know.
Butterflies have these, then they have wings, and then they flutter around like this.
Yeah. Okay, they do. So, do you want to do a vlog? You want to do a vlog, right? You want to do a video like daddy?
Yep.
Okay, you need to be quiet for 30 seconds. Can you do that for daddy?
All right.
Please? Thank you. So, just to summarize, someone's, they're the most important person in their narrative. So, acknowledge them, right? Yeah. If you're going to be emotional, but be emotional about something that person does. Don't use exclamation points or emotional language if you can, especially if you don't know the person, you may offend them. But if you have to, that's who you are, like these little monkeys here, then try to do it about something that that person has done for you to let them know that you're emotional about what they like, right? And third, be sincere. It comes off. And then, you know, when you have friends sometimes, let me finish, I'm almost done. When you have friends, you know, what?
And Abby are my friends.
That's good. And when people are your friends, you can be sincere. And when people are friends, sometimes you can be insincere because they're friends. They forgive you. But we're almost done. Almost done. 10 seconds. 10 seconds. 10 seconds, sweetie.
No, but I haven't had a turn. You did all the time.
You can get it in a minute. Jump. Okay, Maya. And third, be genuine, right? I could have kicked my kids out of the room for doing this vlog, and I'm sorry it went on so long, but they want to be involved, and you know, I like being a dad. So have a great week. I hope you enjoy this. I'll be giving the talk with sans the accompaniment on Friday evening at Tokyo Black Professionals. Please come on out. The details will be in the description below, and have a great week. Say bye, girls.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
I want to try.
You will try right now.